Hello again, people. In today's video, we have got a hedge trimmer. But the thing is, this hedge trimmer's got a bit of a problem. Okay, now, this hedge trimmer, it belongs to my neighbour, and she's bought it round for repair. And, yeah, we'll have a look at what the little problem this hedge trimmer's got. Okay, there's the cutting blade, of course. That flex there, I'll show you what that's for in a minute. But yes, there's the old hedge trimmer there. If we follow the wire all the way around, there's the wire. Can you guess what's happened here? Yes, it's gone pop. Yes. It's a legendary classic, people. You cut on the edge and yeah, you swing it round and chop straight through the flex. And yes, I've had to repair it. Okay. There we go. So there it is. I've had to put the flex in either side, join it up. That middle one's obviously not used because it's an earth terminal. And yeah, that's a class 2 double insulated appliance, so it doesn't need an earth terminal, but I will put that back in there anyway. That's if a darn thing will go back in. There we go. And yes, I'm now just about to give this a little test run. And yeah, there we have it. Now then, I don't know what sort of fault condition happened on this, but let's just say that I have rejoined that back up, and before I started shooting this video, I took the plug, and I tested the fuse in it, and the fuse has gone pop. Yes, I've got a feeling that when that flex was sliced through, there was a bit of a fault condition on that, and it made the fuse go pop. Yes, so I've had to put a new fuse in the plug. And there's all the flex there. Okay, it's got a few tangles in it as well, so I might have to get all those out. Now then, that plug in the socket there, what could be on the other end of that? It's the fun jiggery pokery unit, people. And it's ballasted with a 3 kW water heater. Okay. I don't know what's going to happen here, so if it's that hedge trimmer is going to pop, I just want to slow things down a bit, okay? Because obviously speaking, I'll have hold of that when if it decides it's going to explode. And yeah, I don't want that straight on the mains when I've got hold of it, because as you know with a hedge trimmer, it's a two-handed operation. You've got to press that in, that's like a safety interlock, and then while you're holding that in, you then squeeze the trigger and it turns on. Okay, with that like that, if you just press the trigger, you get no action at all. Okay, so it's a two-handed operation. You press it in first, and then you press that in and it fires up. Okay, but I don't want to do it straight on the mains. Oh, you put that plug in that socket. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to break out with a fun jiggery pokery unit, ballast it with a 3 kW water heater, and then that can go in that socket over there. And yes, if it does decide to go pop, then hopefully it won't be as dramatic as what it would be if it was straight on the mains. Okay, that's the 3 kW water heater there, so really speaking, that socket, in regards to the amount of current you can pull on it, it is wide open. And I don't know what the wattage is on this thing. Let's have a looky, because I haven't had a look yet. Oh, it's 400 watts, there we go. So 400 watts. There it is. Okay. Again, it's got the square inside the square there, which means it's double insulated, so it doesn't need an earth connection. Okay, and it's got all the safety warnings on it, used hearing protection. Safety gloves, maybe goggles as well, and things like that. So there you go. It says on it, Home Retail Group, MK92NW. This darned camera. You know what this camera's like for Zoom, people. Right, and of course, you would have guessed it, it's made in China. But I'm pretty sure if it works, it works. So, I'm now going to power up the fun jiggery pokery unit, and I'm going to take this outside in the garden, and we'll have fire it up on the fun jiggery pokery unit, see what happens. If it goes pop, it's not my problem. So there we go, there's the old fun jiggery pokery unit, and I'm going to get our hedge trimmer now and our plug, and we'll take this out in the garden. And we'll see if it fires up. Nice sunny day, people. It's a nice sunny day. Right, I'm just going to put our plug in the fun jiggery pokery unit. Right, what I'm going to do, just in case that thing does go bang, is I'm going to power it up from this point here. Okay. So that's on, that's on, that's all the way over there, and yes, if it's going to go pop, then it'll do it out there, all the way away from me, and my 3 kilowatt water heater will prevent any fuses from popping, so here we go. Is it? Well, it's not doing anything yet. There's no pops and bangs or any smoke or flames. So, on that note, I would say it's safe to approach. Okay. And don't forget, of course, if I think it's safe to run on full power, I can take out our ballast there and I can use the bypass plug. Put that in there and then that will get full current. Okay. So, I'm going to now go out in the garden and take hold of that hedge trimmer and see if it starts up. Okay, now what I'm going to do is I obviously cannot hold the camera because that thing is a two-handed operation, as I said, with the safety interlock and the trigger. So I'm going to just have to place the camera on the table and you're just going to have to listen to the audio of it. Okay, so I'm now going to approach the hedge trimmer and it's just sitting there. And here we go. Right. I'll just place you there. There we go. You can sit there on the edge of the table. And here's the sound of the hedge trimmer. Sounds good, doesn't it? Right, I'm just going to pop indoors and put that bypass plug in and then see what happens. I think this will be okay. Okay, people, I've put the bypass plug in and here we go. Pretty wet, I reckon. Job done. So there it is. Thanks for watching, people.